Welcome to the part 3 of the Google Calendar tips and tricks. In case you missed the last two parts, please watch them. If you're searching for to improve your planning, improve your productivity using Google Calendar, this is the right video where I'm going to give you 5 simple tips and tricks to make you more productive in your life using Google Calendar. Let's dive in. Thank you for tuning in. Welcome to this part 3. Part 3 means another part 1 and part 2 is waiting for you. In case if you're brand new, just join now. Please hit the pause button and watch the part 1 and part 2 where I have given the basics of the Google Calendar and given 10 tips there, okay? In the part 1, 5 tips, and in the part 2, 5 tips, okay? Please watch them and come back. I hope you watched it. I'm very grateful for it. In this video, I go a little bit even more advanced. I'll give you another 5 tips and tricks of Google Calendar so that you will become even more productive in your life, even more effective in your journey, okay? Let's dive in. The tip number 1 is changing the starting day of the week. For example, can you see here? Usually in the calendar, Sunday to Saturday, okay? Sunday to Saturday. In case, Ramesh, I want a calendar from Monday to Sunday. Yes, we can do that. That's the tip number 1. Click on settings. See here. Scroll down slowly. Somewhere it is here. See this? Start week on. Click on this. Start from Monday. Right? And just refresh. See this? Week started from Monday. If week started from Monday, that's awesome. Right? You can do this. And the second tip I would love to give you is this advanced search. For example, maybe you have done something in the past and you want to search that. Just click on that slash button. You'll get the search bar slash. Okay. You'll get search button. Or if you want to search, you can see this search, this magnifying glass. Click on this. You will get the search here. You can search for, maybe I want to search for my movie time. Where is my movie time? I forget it. Okay. Wow. Can you see it? Every Monday, 11:15 to 1:45, it's my movie time, right? It's my movie time and I know that. So like this, you can search your any task. The best part is you can go to advanced also. For example, you want to search like in all the calendars, or you want to search what is the exact keyword. Suppose if you want to add your partner with whom you are partnering with, you can add their email also. For example, I will add my other email. So I can add this. I don't know if it is coming. So it should come if you are added. And location, for example, in the calendar, you can use location. For example, you are traveling, you can add location also. You can search with locations also. For example, Bangalore. Maybe when are the times I went to the Bangalore in the past? Show me. Just kidding. Okay, this is an example. In case if you want to avoid some keywords, you can add here. Maybe you know the average date. For example, last year, at what time I went to Bangalore? You can search it like January 1st, 2021 to December 31st, 2021. You can search, click on the search button. You will get the data. Awesome, right? Thank you. And the third tip I would love to give you in Google Calendar is, Ramesh, what if I have done all the work? For example, I plan it. For example, I'll show you this calendar. So you plan this whole calendar, and you want to have it in your paper. What if you plan it and you click on that print button? Yes, you can print it out. Click on this gear button. Click on the print, where you'll get an exact printout. It's a printout, okay? If you want a color print, you'll get the color print also. There are a lot of settings available. Like if you want to say day view, you will get the day view. So only today's view, okay? Like 7 days it will come. Total pages 7. Suppose if you want week view, you can say week view also, okay? And see this font size. Suppose if you want even more bigger font, you can change it out. A lot of options available. I love normal. And orientation, suppose you want to print it out in the landscape, you can make it landscape. So the printer will be taken as landscape. And outline, suppose if you want full color, if you are a color printer, make it full, right? This is how you want it, right? Even I expected like this. So take this print out and work on it on the paper. I will prove you, you will get double the productivity just by printing it out. Please printing it out and just using it, okay? In case if you want to avoid weekends, click on this, weekends, you'll get only Monday to Friday, okay? Click on the print button, you'll get a file or you'll get a paper. Got it? This is the fourth tip I would love to give that. And the fifth tip is holidays and other calendars. For example, you want to see all the holidays of your office. You can see here all the holidays, the generic holidays in India. You can see here, for example, see here, there is one festival is there. I don't know what it is. It's a Muslims festival. If you go to the next week, can you see here Ramzan? Ramzan is a general festival in India because it is already there in the calendar, right? Maybe you can turn it off. There is no Ramzan because I turn it off. If you want, turn it on, you will get all the holidays, right? If you want to change the color, you can change the color. Right click on it, you can change the colors also. For example, I want all the holidays should be in orange color so that I can have more fun. Yes, you can have, right? You can change the colors also for the calendars. This is holiday calendar. Suppose you want to add one more layer to this calendar. For example, Hindu calendar, Chinese calendar, Japanese calendar. You can do that. Just click on this gear button. Click on settings. In the settings, you can click on the add calendar, where you can add a new calendar like Hindu calendar, Chinese calendar. Click on the browse calendars of interest. You will get the generic calendars. For example, I want to know Chinese holidays. I want to know Hindu holidays. I want to know Jewish, Muslims, Orthodox. Suppose if you are a sports lover, you can add your like all the events happening in the sports related stuff. In case if you want to know the faces of the moon, you can add all these things, okay? If you click on back, you will see everything like the festivals. See here, all the festivals, all the calendars in one go. And I forget to tell you, in the second part, I told you, right, you grab the Outlook email, Outlook link of the calendar, and you click on the settings where you can add the calendar. See this, add a calendar from URL. From URL, you grab the Outlook URL calendar and paste it here, okay? Paste it here. Once the link is there, you paste it and click on add, okay? Once you add it, all the Outlook, for example, your office meetings, office schedules, office scrum meetings will be come to this Google calendar, so that you can see, you can maintain one calendar and it will be automatically updated. For example, your scrum master added a new meeting in your Outlook calendar, it will be reflected, not immediately, but within 15 minutes, it will be reflected in the Google calendar also. Right? Loud it? Just type loud it in the comments. Thank you. And I hope you enjoyed this series of this three parts of the Google calendar. I'll give a summary of this, the last five tips. The first tip is change the starting day of the week from Sunday to Monday if you want. Second, advance the search based on the need. Third, print the calendar and use it in the paper. Four, you can use add-ons. For example, you can use Keep Notes, you can use Zapier. If you want to go even more advanced as a business owner, you can use this Google Calendar as a part of the automation. For example, if the task is created, send an email to my team member, you can use that, right? And five, use holidays and other calendars also into your calendar. I hope you really enjoyed it. Please implement this and let me know in the comments. First, implement all the 15 tips, okay? And wait for a week and see the magic and type it in the chat. How much productivity has been increased in your life after implementing these 15 tips? Because your action makes me more inspired than your words, okay? Please hit that like button if you really love my work. And if you're really brand new to me, this is Ramesh Yadav, productivity expert. I am a founder of a secret community called Productivity Empire. We are right now 180 plus people while I'm recording this video. Even if you're watching this after 1 year, it would be scaled, okay? And if you want to be a part of my community, click that link below, join my next webinar. I will handhold you how to become effortlessly productive without laziness or distractions. If you believe that the right thing, you can jump into my community and hit the subscribe button so that you will see a lot of valuable sessions I have done till moment, and I will do even more until the rest of my life. Please learn it, implement it, and let me know in the comments. Why not you can share it with your one serious friend, not with the group, at least one serious friend who would love to know this, right? Who would love to implement this series, you know? The best part is if you share the value with someone, right? They will remember you for the rest of your life, okay? Please share this video with one person or with the whole gang. Watch all the three parts. Maybe you got into this channel because someone shared you. You know what? Thank him. Thank him for the amazing value. Thank you for watching. See you in the other videos. If you want to learn more, join my next webinar, live webinar. And this is Ramesh Yadav. See you on the next video. Bye.